This is the city of Haimen, located in the Jiangsu province of China.
The trip seemed really exciting from the start, I think.
I didn't actually know what to expect.
Life here is fast and busy.
I really enjoyed kind of travelling places and seeing lots of different things.
It's such a beautiful country and
I don't know, it's just amazing.
The city was once dubbed the Golden Coastline as it encounters the East China Sea and its northern coast. It is also the sister city of Bendigo in Victoria.
I really wanted to do lots of performing. I thought that would be really fun to travel around China and perform.
To experience different culture.
And it's interesting to see the way people perceive Australia and then now how I perceive China as a very generous and loving country.
If I went home today, I'd still be fine with that because I've definitely seen enough to say that this has been really good so far.
The dominant language here is Mandarin, and very few people speak English. Communication is slow and laborious.
You know, now that I'm in China, I've seen how different China is. It's actually like a really interesting thing.
And get to come to a country, a new country, different country, and meet everybody here and see how the schools work here and then perform with the kids here. And I got to chat with them for hours about their lives and they even said they see Australia as such a beautiful country and it's interesting to see the way people perceive Australia.
I just felt like I had a different sort of connection with them, like because I didn't speak their language and they didn't speak mine.
Because I think like communicating from like another country and like a different culture, but then having sort of the same culture at the same time is like really interesting.
It'd be really, you don't need words, you know, like it was quite, you know, even though, you know, I was probably older than them by 3 or maybe even 4 years, it was kind of weird walking over and I was kind of, well, I was shy.
It was like we were communicating in like a different way, like it was really cool.
We couldn't say it, but then they started singing it, "Oh Macarena," because they were listening so carefully and a lot of them did not know English.
Yeah, I think we can like connect through the notes and music and
it's kind of more special trying to communicate with someone who doesn't speak your language because you work so hard to get the answer and then you're like, oh, I have an understanding now, I know what they mean.
You're just singing, having fun, like just working on our songs and you just felt like a family kind of thing, you're all connected. And
the type of music we do and what it's like to experience our music and how it makes you feel because different types of music express different feelings and so that's been amazing.
Like, I guess it really shows how connected we are, really, and I feel lucky that, you know, we have a sister school over here because it's really interesting, like, meeting and hanging around people that are so different to you, like, but even though they're almost the same.
It's incredible. It's probably one of the greatest experiences I've ever had, like, they're just so lovely. Yeah.
I really enjoy, actually, I think this China trip has made us closer together, and performing with them in front of strangers has really boosted our confidence as a team.
These are four of my favorite things. My life is great.
You can't miss this experience. It's an experience of a lifetime. Even if you've already gone overseas or you've never gone before, it's something you can't replace. Because on a normal holiday, you are just looking at the basis of things. You're seeing a tourist perspective, but in the choir tour, you're actually going inside schools, you're going inside homes, or just inside the world and seeing what it is actually like rather than.
For all future choir members, it is an absolutely the biggest opportunity of a lifetime, and you have to come. It is so fun. You meet so many new people. You learn so much more about the people you already know. And it's just an amazing experience, and you would never be able to do it, probably never again in your life. And it's just such an enjoyable thing that you should just really, really come along and do.
I just say, like, just do it, to be honest. Like, go into the deep end, you know.
So far, so good. So far, so good.
It's a different experience, and you might be scared at the start, but you learn something about yourself, how to handle a situation if you don't like it, or if you like it, the joy of finally doing something you've never done before. You do at least one thing you've never done before, and I think that's so rewarding for people. And so to people that either don't want to do it, haven't done it, or regret not doing it, yeah, I would highly regret it if I didn't do it.
I want to say that I think you should be brave, you know, and not be afraid of anything, not being afraid of taking up opportunities, doing something that seems scary, like even flying over to another country is scary, but I think, you know, don't be scared of anything, be brave, you know, take up the opportunity, and, you know, you'll get really good experiences and at least learn something from it, you know, whether you have a good or bad experience, you're just going to learn heaps by taking up opportunities.
Thank you. 是永世。